chapter, beginning at the 22nd verse, the Lord said to Moses, "Tell Aaron and his sons, this is how you are to bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace." So they put my name on the Israelites, and I will bless them. For just a few moments, my brothers and sisters, please let us preach together from the subject, I declare a blessing. Amen. I declare a blessing. What is now a common response to the body of Christ when we greet one another or come into contact with another is, I'm blessed. When we greet one another, we say, I'm blessed. Even when we answer the phone, we answer by saying, I'm blessed. When we text one another or even email one another, our emails end sometimes by saying, I am blessed. Blessing is a claim that we as the body of Christ have adopted it out of how we greet one another or say hello to one another. It's the way we say goodbye to one another to be blessed. We simply declare to one another, be blessed. We ask and we want each other to be blessed. We want one another to know this evening, beloved, that being blessed is more than a greeting. Yeah. I need you to understand that as we end the old year and begin the new year, that we want and we need the Lord to bless us. Being blessed is more than saying hello, and it's more than saying goodbye. Blessing is more than a badge of honor to tell the world that I am a Christian or that I go to Bethel Church. But being blessed is even more than declaring that I am saved and I am sanctified or fire baptized. Being blessed is knowing that God has made a difference in your life, and being able to testify of the goodness of the Lord to others, that somebody might see Jesus through you. Amen. What does it mean to be blessed? We can admit that we are blessed and highly favored. We can admit that God has opened the windows of heaven and poured out a blessing. We can admit that we have acquired many things over the years, and we can even look back over the last 12 months and declare that the Lord has been good to us. Somebody stood and testified tonight that from January to December, God has been good and the Lord has blessed them. I'm a witness who knows that trusting in God will open up the floodgates of heaven. I am a witness who knows that there was a time that you did not have all that you have right now, but thanks be to God that he blessed you and the blessing of God blew your mind. God has blessed us bigger and better than we could even imagine over the years. And if you let it go back, you can say, thank you, Jesus, that you are a blessing in my life. That when you didn't know how the bills would be paid, God showed up and made a way out of no way. When you didn't know how tuition would be paid, God showed up and made a way out of no way. And when sickness touched your body, God was a healer and was above in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. When you got down on your sanctified knees, you cried out, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. And if God, thou withdraw thyself from me, whither shall I go? We know that God reached down and blessed us. He blessed us and he blessed us. And he blessed you, and he blessed you, and he blessed blessing you right now. Blessing is more than clothes on your back. Blessing is more than shoes on your feet. Blessing is more than the car that you drive. Blessing is more than the house that you live in. And yes, I am blessed because God gave me clothes on my back. Yes, I am blessed because God put shoes on my feet. And yes, I'm blessed because God gave me a car to drive. And yes, I'm blessed because I have a home to live in. But if you never do anything else, I'm still blessed. And if you never provide another blessing, I'm still blessed. I'm blessed because he woke me up this morning and he started me on my way. And I'm blessed because the Lord is good. And if I look back over my life, I know that I know that I know that I know. I know that the Lord has been good. I know that I am blessed. And that blessing comes from God. And nobody can take your blessing from you. A blessing is more than an acquisition. It's more than stuff. Some folk have a whole lot of stuff, but they wake up in the morning surrounded by stuff and can't get out of bed because depression has racked their brains, and they don't have friends to call on, and nobody is there but their stuff. But if you're blessed, you can praise God with a polyester dress on. If you're blessed, you can praise God with bobos on your feet. If you're blessed, you can praise God with the running stockings run up your legs. And you're running for Jesus, but you're not tired yet. If you're blessed, you can praise God with the same suit on, black and white, every Sunday. If you're blessed, you can magnify the Lord because the Lord has been good to you. And when you're blessed, you come to give God the praise. You see, my brothers and sisters, a blessing is more than physical. The car will break down. The clothes will get too tight. The house will always be paying for it and fixing something on it. A blessing is more than emotional. Because sometimes you may not feel like praising him. You've got to walk in authority knowing that you are blessed. You've got to walk in the house of the Lord with your head thrown back. That I've come in here to bless the Lord. I've got to give God some praise. I'm here to give the Lord some praise. I'm not here to show and tell, but I'm here to bless the Lord. I'm here to give God the praise, because if you've been through what I've been through, just this week, you'd be praising God. You'd be dancing in the spirit. You'd be leaping and dancing. I'm blessed. I'm blessed, and I know that I'm blessed. Are there any blessed people in the house tonight? Are there any blessed people in the house tonight that know that you're blessed? Blessed by God's favor. You're blessed. Blessed by God's promise. You're blessed. You're blessed by your Father. You're blessed. You're blessed because the Lord is blessing you right now. Hallelujah. Blessed. Regardless of what it looks like. Blessed. Regardless of what the money is. Blessed. Regardless of what I have. Blessed. It is no secret what God will do. What he's done for others, he'll do the same for you. He'll work out your problem. He'll regulate your mind. He'll fix your body. He'll bless you. So if a blessing is not just physical, and a blessing is not just emotional, then a blessing must be spiritual. A blessing is a spiritual thing. It's a spiritual connection to a cosmic God.
It's a spiritual connection that he is hooked up to you, that in the midst of degradation, in the midst of sin, and in the midst of oppression, that God can lift you up, and that God can empower you to do what the devil in the world says that you cannot do. God blesses you because you are spiritually connected, hooked up to the Holy Father with the Holy Ghost running on the inside. You're blessed. Your blessing is not dependent on you. Rather, your blessing is dependent on God. God's presence in your life is manifested in the blessing that comes from God. And simply put, God blesses who he decides he's going to bless. You want to touch your neighbor and tell him, baby, favor ain't fair. I know I'm blessed. I know you may not even be able to stand it, but I'm blessed because God chose to bless me.
Well, in the text tonight, because all that was the pre to the text, Numbers, the 6th chapter, the 22nd through the 27th verse, Moses is declaring to his brother Aaron and tells Aaron to speak to the children of Israel and tells them, this is how you are to bless the people of God. You want to know how to bless the people of God? You bless the people of God by speaking a blessing upon them. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you. May the Lord God be gracious upon you and give you his peace. We're praying in the spirit tonight that the Lord will bless you and keep you. We're praying in the spirit tonight that God would give you a blessing that will blow your mind. We're praying in the spirit tonight that God would give you a cosmic blessing that is bigger and better than you could ever hope for. And as we end 2015 and move into 2016, I declare a priestly blessing upon the house called Bethel. The priest had the function to declare a blessing upon the people of God. And I stand in my priestly function and I declare, may the Lord God bless you and bless you and bless you and bless you. May the Lord bless you and bless you and bless you and bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord lift you up all year long. When you put running in your feet and clapping in your hands, may God bless you right now in Jesus' name. Amen.